Good morning, class. So in this lecture we are talking about the bioaccumulation and biomagnification. These both terms belongs to pollution biology subject and from chapter number 7. Basically these three terms regarding as like bioaccumulation, biomagnification and bioconcentration. These all three terms regarding to the concentration of pesticides in food chain, entropical levels and the fat cells of living organism. So, in this lecture, we're talking about the bioaccumulation and biomagnification. So, let's start with the biomagnification. What is meant by biomagnification? Biomagnification is also known as the bioamplification. It is the increase in concentration of pollutant that occur in a food chain as a consequence of. Means, biomagnification is a concentration of substances such as the pesticides, heavy metals, or chemical substances which are harmful for the living organism are increase in concentration of this pollutant in the food chain. As we know, the food chain having the different ways, they may be aquatic, terrestrial, aerial or different food chains. So the accumulation of pesticides within that food chain is called as the bioamplification or biomagnification. This biomagnification having the three consequence, that is the three sequence for the persistence of this chemical accumulation. First one, that is persistence, means persistently accumulate these pesticides accumulate in the food chain of living organism. We know that there are many types of food chain are belongs in the ecosystems, so it can't be broken down by the environmental process. As we know, the many microorganisms are act like a they act as a decomposer and they feed on dead and decaying material. Also some organisms are feed on these chemicals which can degrade these chemicals, but the rate of the chemical degradation is very low in the environment, so that these pollutant accumulate in environment persistently and the concentration of these pesticides increase simultaneously in the food chain also. Second one, that is bioenergetics in food chain. As we know, the food chain containing the low rate of energy transport, that means producers having the high rate of the energy production, but for the production of energy, consumers having to feed on the many more substances, so that the bioenergetics is also important phenomenon in bioamplification. And another one, that is low rate of internal degradation and excretion of the substance, often due to the water insolubility. As we know, there are some chemicals that cannot be soluble in our body, such as lead, mercury, these are heavy metals or pesticides. They cannot be degraded in the living organism's body by the enzymatic reactions. So due to this low rate of internal degradation, the accumulation of this concentrated pollutant are increases. So biomagnification occurs when substances such as the pesticides or heavy metals move up food chain by working their way into the environment. As we know, we use pesticides for many purposes in the agriculture. They may be insecticide, molluscicide, weedicide or another many more. So these pesticides also containing the heavy metals. Also, the heavy metals are released from the industrial area. So these heavy metals and pesticides move in the food chain. They may be the aquatic food chain or terrestrial food chain. So these heavy metals and pesticides accumulate in this food chain by working into their way into environment. So for example, the pollutant in river or lakes, as we know, due to the runoff, the pesticides runoff water mix in a runoff water and give accumulated or concentrated in the aquatic ecosystem. So this pollutant concentration are increases in river and lakes, and this taken up by the planktons, that is small planktons, and then these planktons are eaten by the aquatic organisms such as a fish, so which in turn are eaten by the large birds and the animals and humans. So the concentration of these substances are increased in the tissue or internal organism as they move up the chain. So as we know, planktons are a very minute particles which are present in the aquatic ecosystem. So these planktons are eaten by the small fishes. These small fishes is eaten by the large fishes, and these large fishes eaten by the humans or animals or birds. So due to this consequence, or due to this food chain, the concentration of these pesticides increases in the food chain. So as a result of organism at the top of the food chain generally suffer greater harm from the persistent toxin or pollutant than those at the lower level. So the organism at the top of the food chain, that is the humans are at the top of the food chain, are generally suffer greater harm for the persistent toxin or pollutant than the those of the lower level. Planktons having the very low rate of concentration of pesticides in their body, but the humans or animals or birds having the high rate of the concentration of this pollutant in their body. So because of this, at each level of food chain there is a lot of energy loss. Basically, we know that the each food chain containing producers and consumers. Consumer may be primary consumer, secondary consumer, or tertiary consumers. So at each level of food chain there is a lot of energy loss. So predator must have to consume many prey. So due to this, including all their lymphophilic substances and fats which carries the pollutant, which then accumulate in the fats of the predators. So due to this energy loss, predators have to recover this energy loss by feeding the more prey. So by the feeding the more prey, it accumulates the more pollutant in their body. So that, because predators feed on the fats, lipids and the lipophilic substances of the prey, so that the accumulation of these pesticides occur in the top level of the food chain. So in this figure you can see that the accumulation of methyl mercury, how it occur. So basically methyl mercury is a byproduct of the industrial waste. So this methyl mercury, we can see that these are the producers. So firstly, the methyl mercury having the low concentration in producers. So by the feeding of these producers, small fishes feed on the planktons. These planktons feed on the these aquatic plants. This then small fishes feed on the planktons, then large fishes feed on the small planktons, and then birds feed on the large fishes or human or the birds. So these animals, birds and the humans are the higher in the food chain level, so that the accumulation or concentration of these methyl mercury is increases in the top level of the food chain due to the feeding of the prey more, to gain the more energy for the predators. So biomagnification can be occur in almost all types of ecosystem. There may be terrestrial ecosystem, aquatic ecosystem or aerial ecosystem. Because this pollutant having the polluted by air, water and the soil also. So due to this, the biomagnification, that is the accumulation of the pesticides in the body of organism by the food chain, are generally found in the all types of ecosystem. So this is the rate of the biomagnification in the organism's body. So in this you can see that the first primary consumers having the very low rate of the accumulation or biomagnification, that is part per trillion. Then the secondary consumers having the part per billion accumulation. Then tertiary consumers having the one part per million accumulation, and the top level of the consumers having the 10 parts per million biomagnification of the pesticides in their body. So due to this accumulation, there are many diseases can be found in the living organisms. So biomagnification, when the contaminants increases in each step of food chain. So as we know that biomagnification means the contaminants, that is the pollutant, that means pesticides, heavy metals or other chemical elements which are harmful for the living organism are increases in each step of the food chain. Okay, they may be the terrestrial food chain, they may be the aquatic food chain or other food chain which possess in the ecosystems. So the concentration of these pesticides increases by the consumers. So producers having the low rate of biomagnification, whereas the top of the tertiary consumer having the highest biomagnification of the pesticides or heavy metals. So in this figure you can see that the how the concentration of pesticides or pollutant increases by the food chain. So basically producers having just a 0.04 ppm concentration of the pollutant, whereas the primary consumers having the concentration that is 0.23 ppm, that is part per million, whereas secondary consumer having the more concentration or biomagnification of the pollutant, that is 2.07 ppm, that is part per million, whereas tertiary consumer having the highest biomagnification of pesticides and pollutant, that is 13.8 ppm. So this biomagnification occurs in the food chains. Another term, that is bioaccumulation. Bioaccumulation, that is means the toxic substances that increase in concentration in tissue of the living organism. They enter the organism through contaminated air, water, food, and they are very slowly metabolized or excreted. So bioaccumulation also, that is the it is the concentration of toxic substances which increases in the tissue of living organism. So how they enter in the body of organism, there are various way like food, air, water, so they can be very slowly metabolized or excreted. As we know, there are no enzyme system are possessed in the living organism for the degradation of these heavy metals and pollutants, so that these pollutants or heavy metals are accumulated in the body of living organism. So there are some differences in the bioaccumulation and biomagnification. So what is this differences? That is, bioaccumulation is the concentration of pollutant from the environment which occur within a trophic level. Okay, so bioaccumulation means the concentration of pollutant from the environment which occur within a trophic level. As we know, each food chain having the trophic level, that is producer, then primary consumer, secondary consumer, tertiary consumer and the topmost, where the biomagnification is the concentration of pollutant across the food chain. So food chain may be differentiated in the various way. They may be aquatic food chain, terrestrial food chain or other food chain. So these food chains are interlinked, so that the bio accumulation and biomagnification having the difference. So in this figure you can see that the bioaccumulation, how the bioaccumulation and biomagnification is take place. So this blue color determine the contaminant level. So bioaccumulation occur in the trophic level, that is the each trophic level of the organism. So in this figure you can see that these fishes having the accumulation of the pesticide in their body. So these are the same species of the fishes which accumulate the pesticides in their living tissue, whereas biomagnification means the contaminant or the pollutants are accumulated or get concentrated in the food chain. So basically we know that the small fishes feed on the zooplanktons, then large fishes feed on the small fishes, and the bear feed on the large fishes. So due to this, the biomagnification is applicable. So in this figure you can see that the biomagnification, bioaccumulation occur in the single organism of the trophic level, but biomagnification means it occur in the food chain. Okay, so one by one it accumulated or get concentrated in the living organism's body. So we are concerned about the phenomenon because together they mean the even small concentration of chemical in the environment can find their way into the organism in high enough doses to cause the problem. So basically we know that this small amount of chemicals can be interfere in the enzymatic reactions of the living organism, so which may be harmful for the living organism to for the survival of their living. So in this figure you can see that so there are many accumulation or biomagnification occur in the living organism. So there are many way of chemical end up in the lake and river, including the wind and rain runoff. So basically these pesticides get accumulated in aquatic system by the wind or the rain runoff water. So as we know, pesticides are used in the aquatic ecosystem. Pesticides used in the agriculture for the purpose of crop yielding. So because of these pesticide residue are remain in the soil. Whenever the rain falls, these pesticides get soluble in the water, and this runoff water get mixed in the aquatic ecosystem. So these chemicals sink into the bottom of the lake or river, where they settle in the sediments. So the small creature which is called as the macrovertebrates eat these chemicals as they dig in the sediment for the food. So these microvertebrates are eaten by the minnows, or minnows by the medium sized fish, and those fish are eaten by the large fish. So each collecting and storing the some of the chemicals in their body. So this is why the larger fish, predator fish, and the longer living fish are likely to have the more chemicals in their bodies than the smaller angle fish. So check the Eat Safe Fish guide to find the safe fish. So basically the largest fish or long living fish having the high contaminant or high pollutant concentration in their living body. So in order for the biomagnification to occur, the pollutant must be long lived, mobile, soluble in fats, and biological active, that is persistent. As we know, so biomagnification occurs in the food chains. So this pollutant may be long lived. So this pollutant may be long lived because short lived pollutant may be degraded by the environmental microorganism. So this pollutant, for the accumulation of the pollutant, they may be longer lived, such as the mercury, lead, many pesticides, chemicals, plastic, which does not degrade in the environment by the microorganism. So they are the long live. Secondly, they are mobile because they constantly release in the environment, and constantly their concentration are increases. Another one, that is soluble in fats. Whenever they get accumulated in body of the organism, they may be soluble in fat, so that they can be stored in the fat of the living organism, and they are biologically active. Okay, so due to this persistency, the concentration of this pollutant are increases day by day. So in this figure you can see that in 1970 the factory which put out the lots of persistent chemical through the its smoke stack. Nowadays, first of all, in 1970, so there are many industries are flourish, so they introduce their waste, that is industrial waste, into the aquatic ecosystem, air and water bodies. So due to the this factories, the accumulation or biomagnification of these persistent chemicals through the smoke or through the industrial waste are occurring in the living aquatic ecosystem. But in 2011, these factories has the pollution control devices on its smokestack. But the chemicals which persistently accumulated or get magnified in aquatic ecosystem are still remain behind. They cannot be removed from that aquatic ecosystem, so that the bioaccumulation and biomagnification occur in that ecosystem. So there are two types of pollutant, that is persistent pollutant which live longer, and another one that is short-lived pollutant. Persistent pollutant means the pollutant that which dissolve in fast, which is called as the persistent pollutant and retain for the long time. And if the pollutant is short-lived, it will be broken down before it can become a dangerous. So, persistent pollutant which is having the long life are maybe dissolved in the fats and remain deposited in the fat body of the organism. Whereas, short-lived pollutant are break down by the microorganism before they become a dangerous for the living organism. Another one difference, that is lipid or fat soluble substances cannot be diluted, broken down or excreted in urine. As we know, lipid or fat soluble substances are stored in the body of organism so that they cannot be diluted, they cannot be break down by the enzymatic reaction, or they cannot be excreted through the urine, so that they are deposited in the body of organism. Short lived pollutant, if it is not mobile, it will stay in one place and it is unlikely to be taken by the organism. So, if they are not mobile, they will stay in one place and taken up by the organism. But this short-lived pollutant can be break down in the organism's body and can be excreted through the urine from the body of organism. Another difference, that is they accumulate in fatty tissue of the organism if the organism lack enzyme to degrade them. So basically these persistent pollutants accumulate in the fat body of living organism because organism lack the enzymes which can degrade these chemicals in the body of organism, so that they are deposited in the fat body of living organism. And short-lived pollutant, these are soluble in water and excreted by the organism in a form of urine, so that these persistent pollutant are harmful for the living organism because they accumulated in the body of organism, such as DDT, that is dichlorodiphenyl trichloroethane, chlorinated hydrocarbon used as a pesticide. We know that DDT has a half-life, that is 15 years, which means if you use 100 kg DDT, it will break down as follow. So basically it remain for many years. So some are the substances are used as a pesticides for the purpose of crop yielding, that is PCB, that is polychlorinated biphenyls. This substance is insulator in transformers, plasticizer, fire retardant, and impair the reproduction. So it having the problem, that is the if it get accumulated in the body organism, it can be harmful for the reproductive system of the organism. PHA, that is polynuclear aromatic hydrocarbon. These hydrocarbons are useful for the component of the petroleum product, but they are the carcinogenic for the living organism, which can cause the cancer in the living organism. Then another substance, that is heavy metals such as mercury, copper, cadmium, chromium, lead, nickel, zinc, tin. So these heavy metals are useful in various way. For example, mercury from gold mining, many form of metal processing. So these heavy metals are used for the metal processing, but the problem of these heavy metals, when they accumulated in the organism body, they can affect the nervous system of organism's body, and also it affect the reproduction of living organism. Another substance, that is cyanide. Basically cyanide is used in a leaching of gold, and also is used in fishing. but it having this side effect as it is a very toxic for the living organism. Another substance that is selenium, it is concentrated from the forming desert soil and it having the effect on the reproductive system of living organism. Also, it is very toxic for the living organism. So measuring the pollutant, so amount of pollutant is measured in fatty tissue of the organism such as a fish. So basically the concentration of pollutant or amount of pollutant is measured by the fatty tissue of organism such as a fish. The organism which containing how much fatty tissue in the living organism can be calculated its amount of pollutant. Also we often use the milk for the feeding purpose. So this pollutant are accumulated or biomagnificated in this food chain of living organism. So that is for today. So in today's lecture we are talking about the two terms, that is biomagnification and bioaccumulation. Biomagnification deals with the food chain, whereas the bioaccumulation deals with the trophic level. Each trophic level having the how much amount of the pollutant or toxin accumulated in the body of living organism. So in next term we're talking about the bioconcentration term. So that is for today. Thank you.